This is how to replace the water pump pulley on the Subaru FB20 and FB25 engines. While we will be installing a lightweight aftermarket replacement, these directions will work for an original style pulley as well. Put on your protective eyewear and make sure that during this process, the engine won't start. It's also best to do this when the engine is completely cooled down because you will have to stick your hand pretty close to exhaust parts. Begin by popping the hood, lifting it, and putting the hood prop in place. Locate any engine trim that will be in the way of belt access, such as this cover, that is held on with one bolt and one push-in pin. Before we remove the belt, we need to break loose the three bolts that hold the pulley on. They were on tight, so I put a plastic trim tool in the belt so that it would keep the pulley from being able to turn the belt. Once all three bolts are loose, pull that tool back out. Now we will remove the belt. Grab a 17mm socket, either a deep wall or a regular socket with a small extension, and put it on this fake bolt head. Rotate the tensioner until you can take the belt off the alternator pulley, and then gently let the tension off. Be careful, there's a lot of tension there and lots of places to get pinched. The belt can be removed completely or just left in place like I've done here. Reach in and loosen the bolts by hand and be careful not to drop them. Once all three bolts are out, you can remove the pulley. It will likely be stuck on there, so you can use a plastic-handled tool to pry it off, using the engine as a leverage point. While you have the belt off, it's a good time to check that your other pulleys are in good shape. Check for general damage as well as bearing play and noise. Before I installed the new pulley, I was curious to know how much lighter it was than the original. It's definitely lighter. While that's a benefit, it's not something you would really feel. I was also curious if they made the effective diameter of the pulley slightly larger, as this would effectively make the water pump easier to turn at the cost of pump speed. It looks like they have, but it's such a small size difference that it too likely won't be felt. Now we're going to install the new pulley. I cleaned off the bolts with a wire brush and installed some blue thread locker gel, which wasn't required, but I like to add it for peace of mind. You can also use some sandpaper to take off some of the rust where the pulley will be mounted, but I didn't. Thread the bolts on by hand for now, we will do a final tightening later. While hand tightening, make sure that the pulley seats fully so it's in line with the others. Make sure you actually check that because it's the most likely place for a mistake to be made during this process that won't get noticed until the belt gets shredded. When the bolts are all reasonably threaded in, it's time to put the belt back on. Once it has been properly routed around everything but the alternator pulley, put your 17mm socket through the inside of the loop of the belt, bend back the tensioner, and push the belt into the alternator pulley. Make sure you get all the grooves aligned correctly. With the belt in place, the bolts can now receive their final torque. I'll put the most up-to-date torque specs I can find in the video description, along with links to some of the tools and stuff I used to complete this repair. If the pulley is slipping on the belt when you go to torque the bolts, I found that pushing down on the belt helps the belt grip the pulley enough to reach the proper torque spec. If your belt is glazed over, it may still slip, but a glazed over belt should be replaced. Also, since the belt will be putting uneven pressure on the pulley, make sure you rotate the pulley 180 degrees and check the torque again. Before starting the engine, give the belt and pulley alignment one last check. Once you've confirmed that, you can start the engine up to confirm your replacement was a success and no new noises are occurring. Thanks for watching. Consider subscribing because we have more Subaru content in the works, both maintenance and modifications.